Well, that night I came from a party on 3rd Avenue with some friends, and I was going home, and that's when I was stopped by police officers, and they was explaining to me that there was a guy in one of their police cars that was saying that I allegedly robbed them, and they had searched me, and the guy actually said, at first he said I robbed him, and I didn't have anything on me. And that's
you say nothing, you mean no weapon and none of his property?
No weapon, no money, anything he said that I allegedly robbed him for.
They told me freeze, I can't run far. So now I'm stuck, handcuffed inside the cop car. Told me I'm wanted in connection with a robbery. The witness said he wasn't sure, but it was probably me. Told him I'm innocent, I swear it really wasn't me. The cop laughed and just kept on fingerprinting me. Asked me my age and I told him barely 16. Read me my rights, didn't know what them shits mean. Inside a room, the lady asking me like where I was. Taking pictures of my tats, was I crippled blood? I repeat, I wasn't there, I was in my home. Are y'all finished? Are y'all done? Now can I go home? They put me back inside a cell with that pissy smell. When niggas laying on the bench and on the floor as well. Bullpen, cheese sandwiches, I wasn't smiling. At my arraignment, judge told him take me to the island. He said, bail, what the hell? I can't post that. My mama poor, all this over a backpack. The full building where they took me, I heard stories about. Where adolescents chew rocks and spit razors out. Just a boy, but they forcing me to be a man. And my Pataki's in the day room got me throwing hands. They trying to jump me, but I'm fighting back with all my might. Dirty CO's just watching, let them beat me twice. This can't be life, got me thinking I should take my own. At nights I cry, fantasizing that they send me home. I miss my family, these days turning into months. Riding to that courthouse on this filthy bus. I want my trial, but the DA say they still ain't ready. And since I fight back, they putting me in solitary. 23 locked down, ain't no commissary. Write letters, stand strong, mama, don't you worry. I feel trapped, got me living with a mice at. I feel darkness in this cage where the lights at. Count the bricks on the wall, think I lost my mind. I can't take it lately, contemplating suicide. I can't believe I've been here and 3 years passed. All charges dropped, finally being free at last. My whole family is happy that I'm finally back. But what they took from me, I am never getting back. Look how they stole my childhood and they beat me so. Coming home slightly different than I was before. It was horror, all the memories at night haunt me. Waking up screaming, thinking that the CO's on me. I'm hearing voices now, I'm paranoid, who do I trust? Trying to find my way, getting harder to adjust. I can't take it, please somebody get this pressure off me. Man, I'm feeling like God ain't throw a blessing towards me. I feel in love, but the demons in my head is louder. The court appointed lawyer that they gave me did me fouler. I'm depressed, sorry mama, couldn't make you prouder. I give up, take my own life, Khalif Browder.
The judge told me that if I plead guilty, I would be released from jail that same day. But I didn't do it. You're not gonna make me say I did something just so I could go home.
When we first met him, November of last year, he was doing better, he said. Earned his GED, started classes at Bronx Community College, pulling a 3.56 GPA. But the psychological trauma from jail had taken its toll.
When he first came home, he would just walk the four corners of the driveway.
You hear animals do that have been confined to a space.
Yes, he did it. And I had to watch my baby go through all of that.
In the last year, Khalif grew depressed, deeply paranoid.
You know, deep down, I'm a mess. I feel like I'm a grown old man.
And then two Saturdays ago, 2 years after his release from jail, Khalif Browder hanged himself with an air conditioner cord in his home in the Bronx. He was 22.